than one person reading the entire ledger. Say we had more people to help, like the staff of your accounting department. We'll split them into two groups, called the mappers and the reducers. Then we'll take the ledger, break it into chunks, give each chunk to one of the mappers. That way, all the mappers can work at the same time, each over a small fraction of the data. Let's see what a mapper would do. They will take the first record in their ledger and on an index card, write the name of the store and the amount of the sale. Then they'll take the next record and repeat. As they're writing the index cards, they'll pile them up so that cards for the same store go in the same pile. By the end, each mapper will have a pile of cards per store. Once the mappers have finished, the reducers can collect their sets of cards. We'll tell each reducer which store they're responsible for, such as this one for New York City and this one for Miami and Los Angeles. The reducers go to the mappers and retrieve the pile of cards for their stores. It's fast for them to do because the mappers have already separated the cards into a pile per store. Once the reducers have retrieved all their data, they collect all the small piles and create a larger pile. Then they start going through the piles one at a time. All they have to do at this point is add up all the amounts from all the cards in the pile. That gives them a total sales for that store. They can then write that amount on their final sheet. To keep things organized, each reducer goes through his or her set of piles in alphabetical order. In other words, Los Angeles before Miami.